The third row on the display contains the duplex/combined shortcut buttons. Each button on this row has two images. The image on the left represents your original, and the image on the right represents your desired copy output. This row can be customized. By default, the button on the far left is the one-sided originals to two-sided copy with a top-to-top flip. The next button on that row is two-sided originals to two-sided copies with a top-to-top flip. The third and fourth buttons will shrink full-sized originals so that two pages will fit on one page, or four originals will be reduced to fit onto one page. Next in line on the third row on the display is the Create Margin button. Selecting this will reduce the image to 93% of its original size and places the reduced image at the center of the page. This will give you a wider margin for binding or hole punching. New for the MPC 4503 is the ID Card Copy button. Selecting this will copy the front and back of an ID card or other small original onto one side of a sheet of paper. The fourth row of shortcut displays the installed finishing options. This row can also be customized to the most frequently used buttons and could be different for each machine since they may not all have the same finisher. We are using a machine with an SR3140 finisher. The first button on this row is Sort, which when selected will collate your output in a 1-2-3 page order. The second button is Stack, which when selected will put your copied output in stacks of page 1, then a stack of page 2, then a stack of page 3, etc. If you do not choose Sort or Stack, the machine will automatically stack. If you always want your documents collated or sorted, the Sort option can be set as a default setting on the display. The fifth row of buttons on the display are what I refer to as the super functions and will be discussed in another training module.